So hi Krishna, Chaitanya, Shrivam Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
So you were just speaking about how sometimes, you know, we kind of have to be retreat or be humble in that way, and other times we need to be step forward and, you know, take action. And Srila Prabhupada was sometimes quoted for saying, you know, humility means being bold for Krishna. And especially in this time right now where there's so many changes and so many opportunities for us as devotees to preach. And, you know, we have now, we're using technology so much. How do we ensure that, you know, when we are engaging in activities online or, you know, through technology to preach, that we that it doesn't become all about us, and it's not about, you know, kind of displaying our ego or you know, making all of our online activities about who we are, especially with social media and things like that?
So are you saying that social media makes it difficult to be humble or tolerant, or what is the relationship between the two exactly?
How do we prevent ourselves from, yes, because often it can seem like, you know, when we're putting ourselves out there to preach, you know, with the goal of preaching, that, you know, it's a lot of self-promotion. And so how do we make sure that we don't?
I got the question. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So social media often requires self-promotion. But then how can we be humble if we are also being self-promoting? Well, it's more a matter of what our purpose is. Humility involves certain actions externally, but more than that, it involves the intentions internally. So if Srila Prabhupada, when he came to India, and some of his disciples, some of his lady disciples had gone to Jaipur to get the deities of Krishna made over there. And while they were there, their sincere devotion that attracted many of the influential people of Jaipur. And through them, these lady disciples of Srila Prabhupada arranged a pandal program for Prabhupada. And Prabhupada was very delighted and proud of his disciples. He says that they are organizing a big program for me, that even his lady disciples can do extraordinary things. So then eventually when Prabhupada came there, he saw the posters, and the poster said Prabhupada and his foreign disciples. And Prabhupada said, you know, why just foreign disciples? Right there, Prabhupada and his American and British disciples. Now, Prabhupada actually had the posters changed over there. Now, why American and British? I'm going to say that actually in India, Britain was the former ruler and America was the land of opportunity, land of dreams. So those two countries at one level, we could say that they had much more respect and appeal in the Indian eyes than just a generic word foreign. And Prabhupada's strategy had been that because Indians were enamored by the West, so he wanted to demonstrate how even Western people were exploring life's spiritual side and finding answers to spiritual questions in the Indian wisdom tradition. And therefore, Indians should also explore that same tradition, not neglect that. So now for his strategy to be effective, he had done his part. He had been gone to the West and courageously shared Krishna Bhakti and had been able to get, inspire people to take up Bhakti. But now that had to be communicated. So Prabhupada was specific about that. That changed that. So is that self-promotion? It can seem like it. So similarly, on social media, there are certain forums where one needs to promote oneself. Because in normal life, we could say that visibility is a function of growth. That, you know, the bigger one is, the more visible one is. That is true, but in social media, growth is a function of visibility. It works the other way also, that the more visible you are, only then people can connect and you can grow. So if something is required for a particular service, then doing that is not necessarily against the principle of humility. So what would be the against the principle of humility is where one is constantly seeking honor and recognition and fame. Say if somebody is on social media and they have a lot of followers, but when you meet them, we can easily make out people who are, you could say, drunk with themselves. Drunk with themselves means if you're talking with them also, they will keep reminding, I have this many followers and I have done this and, this post got this much view, and they're talking about themselves. And so it's that they are their mission. I could put it succinctly is that they are their mission, not that their message is their mission. So if that means if they use whatever visibility they have to promote the message that they want to share, then that is not self, that is not against the principle of humility. Because we want Krishna to be glorified. And if Krishna is to be glorified, Krishna, we need to ensure that the message of Krishna has the appropriate forums. If those forums are not there, then then how will the glorification be done? And for that, but once you get those forums, if you just start talking about ourselves, then that is a problem. But if you are talking about ourselves so that the message gets heard more. So if our focus is on help providing others tools for raising their consciousness, and Krishna's message is a very potent tool for raising people's consciousness, and for that purpose we are using the visibility that we have, then I don't think that's against the principles of humility. So two things. One is the intention of why we are doing it, and the other is, now, what do we actually use it for? So we can very easily make out where there is a personality cult. That means it's more about or more or entirely about the person itself and not so much about the mission or the message. It is just about the person. Then it goes in the direction of being a personality cult and self-promotion without divorced from any higher purpose. But if we are serving the purpose of sharing Krishna's message and mission, then one way to understand this is that apart from the present being the way we are present, somebody is present in social media, during their normal interactions, are they down to earth? Are they constantly talking about themselves, or are they expressing concern for others? Are they focused on the particular mission that they are trying to promote? We consider these things, then we will be able to get a better hold on humility despite the demands of social media. Does that make sense? Thank you.
Yes, it does. Thank you.